Hey watchers, it's your girl Big Ish. I've been gone for a while, but a sister is back and I'm ready to review Tyler Perry's Netflix original A Fall From Grace. Okay, so let me give you the plot. Jasmine Bryant, who's played by Bresha Webb, is a public defender, okay? Jasmine constantly takes plea deals in her small town. She's known for that. She has a husband, his name is Jordan, and he's a police officer. She also has a boss in her law firm whose name is Rory, and that's played by Tyler Perry. Rory gives her a case that involves Grace Waters. Now, Grace Waters is played by Crystal Fox. She's the woman accused of murdering her husband, Shannon. Now, Shannon is played by Makai Brooks. Grace insists that she's guilty and only wants a plea deal if she goes to a prison close to her son, Malcolm. Jasmine notices that there are a lot of holes in her story and a few things are off about the case, including the fact that Shannon's body is missing. Okay, so this movie is taking a serious beating, you guys. People hate this movie. But I have to say, for me, I did enjoy it. I do agree there were some problems with editing and production. The blocking was weird on a lot of the angles. The lighting was a little drab in certain areas, but for me, overall, the writing in the movie was good. The plot was good, and the actors were amazing. What's really getting people upset is these wigs, you guys. They are roasting these hairdos. Take a look. I mean, people are just talking about how Tyler Perry has a history of putting men in bad wigs, and it's just hilarious. Okay, the wigs are funny. I'll give them that. Another thing that grabbed my attention about what was driving people in Black Twitter, and particularly crazy, was how one of the extras was caught eating and drinking air. Take a look. Now, I get it. You know, some of this was definitely a production problem. And yes, Tyler Perry is responsible for production because he does his own. But, you know, you guys are being a little bit nitpicky, I think. Yes, that is a problem. But overall, the movie was pretty good. Now, let's not forget when Game of Thrones did the same thing when they had a Starbucks cup in one of their episodes and also a water bottle. I've even heard people try to say that the acting in this film wasn't good, which is totally ridiculous to me. Bresha Webb, this was some of her best acting that I've ever seen. Felicia Rashad, Cicely Tyson, these two are seasoned thespians, so I don't know where people are trying to go with that one. People also talked about the writing in the film and that it wasn't realistic, which is another concept that I think is ridiculous. This is not a documentary. It's not going to mimic real life 100%. It's supposed to be an escape from your day-to-day life. Of course, all of the things aren't going to add up because it's just fantasy. It's just fairy tale. And these are the same people that go on Lifetime and watch, you know, My Priest is a Transgender Axe Killer. You know, and they don't complain about that, but yet you complain about this. It was Alfred Hitchcock that said, "People want movies to be a slice of life, but I want movies to be a slice of cake." And what that translates to is, it's just entertainment. People, like, just enjoy it, okay? Just eat the cake and enjoy it. Eat the cake, anime. Dang. Okay, so that's it for me and my review of Tyler Perry's Netflix original, A Fall From Grace. And for me, it was one of his better movies. There are a few movies that I like of his, and this was one of the better ones. So, you know, comment, like, and subscribe to my channel. Let me know what you think of the movie. I know there's a lot of mixed reviews on it, but either way, like Tyler Perry said, people are watching. And until next time, this is your girl, Big Ish. Bye!